good. Hope you all are doing great. Welcome back to my channel for yet another video. If you're new here, hello, my name is Brielle and welcome to this side of YouTube. So today I'm going to talk about how the ocean is always deeper than it seems, but people only look at the surface, you know, and it's not good to only look at things on the surface level because it is that deep. Everything is, in fact, that deep. My apologies for the background noise, y'all. So just bear with me, okay? Yeah, so as I was saying, in our everyday life, you know, like this applies to nothing in particular, but everything in general, you know, like, don't be taking things lightly. Everything in life, look at it from a deeper angle, because majority of the time it is like that deep, as I said, you know. Most of the people, like I hear most of the people, just when it comes to life in general, or like the things that people go through, or the things that people see in life, like I hear most of the people talking about, you know, it's never that serious. And I'm like, like, that's the kind of mentality that will get you into hot soup, you know, like you, it's never that serious your way to hell or to destruction, you know, because actually it is that serious, you know, like, don't take things lightly, take everything at a deeper angle, you know, when it, like, be it relationships, friendships, your work, your, basically anything in your life, look at it from a deeper angle, you know, don't allow the mentality of the world trick you into thinking that, you know, you can just carry things and look at things on the surface level and you'll be good, you know, because that's what the enemy wants you to, like, that's how the enemy wants you to operate. He doesn't want you to take things seriously so that he can come in and take advantage, you get me? So there is one thing from the Bible that I want to speak of, you know, where the Lord is telling us, like, you know, like, what relation is there between a believer and an unbeliever, you know? And my question to you guys today is that, you know, what business do you have with people with whom you're not equally yoked, you know? Like, the Lord tells us you should find people who you're equally yoked, and from the Bible's perspective it is believers, you know, but I want to incorporate that into this by telling you, like, if someone is unequally yoked with you, then y'all are not gonna get anywhere. You're gonna bump, like, roads at some point. If you don't share the same values, y'all are gonna end up having a battle, you know, or a warfare. You know, most people, like, okay, everyone, it applies to everyone. Like, people usually hide behind, you know, jokes and like actions, day-to-day lives, you know, but unless you look like through them, you won't be able to tell whether this person is genuine or they're joking, you know. And I know sometimes, like, people will crack jokes and, like, you know, for the sake of laughter and everything, but I want you guys to know the difference between, you know, when someone is subliminally doing something and when they're actually being serious about it, you know, because sometimes we'll end up letting things slide just because, you know, it's been fed into your mind that, you know, oh, this person is like this, just get used to it, or like the situation is always like that, get used to it. Like, do not program yourself to be able to accept mediocrity and like just a lot of crap because someone is telling you that, you know, it's always like this. Remember, what you speak over your life matters, you know, and if you don't align with something, do not program yourself to align with that thing just because you've been told that, you know, it's like this or it's like that. Like, once you've made a decision and you know deep down in your heart that, you know, this doesn't align or I don't like this, like, stick to it and let people respect what you're putting on the table, you know, because how you allow people and things to come to pass in your life is how people are gonna continue relating with you, you know. So if you allow someone to always be giving subliminal disses and you're like, okay, I understand this person is like this, well, guess what, he or she is not gonna stop throwing subliminal disses at you just because they know you can take it, you know. And sometimes these people will indirectly curse you or your life in the name of jokes, in the name of disses, you know. Like, take your life seriously. I want you guys to take your life seriously and everything that happens in your life seriously. If you don't like something, stick by it and tell a person, like, whatever you're doing is not aligning with me and I need you to stop, you know. Let them call you sensitive, let them call you all the names in the world, but you're standing on business because you know words are very powerful when it comes to you and your life. And if at all you pass a point across and people start behaving weirdly towards you, then you just know that these people do not have your best interest at heart. And that will be your cue to like cut ties and separate yourself, you know, because not everyone can be in your life, not everybody can fit into your, you know, your day-to-day activities, and that's totally okay, you know. Like, you don't have to get along with everyone, just find your tribe and like people who respect you, people who respect your boundaries, people who understand you, you know. And sometimes even the people who you relate well with will sometimes misunderstand you, you know, and that's totally okay, you know. So life is not a straight line, you know, but one thing I want you guys to do is to always look at things from a deeper angle. Don't be deceived by that notion that, you know, it's never that serious, because you will dig your own grave when you think like that, you know. Like, things are serious. Life is a matter of fact very serious, you know. Like, don't let people deceive you into, you know, saying I'm here for a good time, not a long time. Like, yes, no one is denying for you to have a good time, but like, be wise while you're having that good time, you know. Yeah, so thank you so much for listening to me to this point, if at all you've listened to this point. And you guys take care, and I'll catch you in my next video. So adios.